Okay, so today we're going to talk about relations and functions. And so in order to do that, we need to talk about the Cartesian product. So let's suppose that A and B are sets. And we want to set the Cartesian product of A and B to be equal to the set of all ordered pairs AB, such that A is in A and B is in B. And I need to tell you what I mean by an ordered pair. And this one is also a subtle definition. So the ordered pair AB is going to be the set that consists of two elements. One of the elements is A, and the other element is the set consisting of A and B. So the ordered pair AB corresponds to a set. The set has two elements. One element is a singleton, and the other element is a pair of elements. So that's what we mean by the ordered pair. Now, that's not operationally how we work with it, but when we need to get back to first principles, that's how we will work with it. So this is just going to be the set of AB, such that A is in A, B is in B. Of course, if A is something like the set 1, 2, 3, and B is something like the set X, Y, then the set of ordered pairs, A times B, A Cartesian product B, would be the set of pairs 1X, 2X, 3X, or 1y, 2y, 3y. And more explicitly, if we think about 1, 2, 3 as living along the horizon and x and y as living along the vertical, then our ordered pairs 1x, 2x, 3x, 1y, 2y, 3y will be those 6 points there. Okay, so we have the numeric axis, we have the alphabetic axis, and then the Cartesian product will be the set of pairs, and that's why it's called a product. Now, a relation between A and B is a subset of A cross B. Now, I should say that the relation is from A to B because a priori I've put B second. So we might say from A to B. And schematically, the way we think about relations, for example, suppose A is the real line and B is the real line, then A cross B is the Cartesian plane, and then a relation is just some subset of the Cartesian plane. Doesn't seem like a very powerful notion, but the reason that we have to introduce the notion is because we want to define what a function is. So a function is a relation such that, let's say it's a relation from x to y. So a function is a relation from x to y such that if x y is in that relation, and x, z is in the relation, then y is identically z. So, and if that's the case, we'll write that element as f of x. So a function is a set of ordered pairs some set of ordered pairs where for each x there's a unique value y. That's the way you're used to thinking about it. Now, the reason we're thinking about functions this way is that we have to be able to talk about a very broad class of functions. We have to talk about functions in a lot of different contexts. And what we'll write is we'll write the function goes from x to y. Now, this is not standard book notation, but it's better, and I'll show you why in just a moment. So if you have a function from x to y, and you have a function from y to z, I guess I need a little bit more notation here. The domain of the function is the set of x's for which we're in the relation. The image is the set of y which land in the relation. And so in this case, we need that the image of f is equal to the domain, or rather is contained inside the domain of g. And then we can form the composition G circle F. And G circle F will be the set of all x, z, such that z is equal to g of y, and y is equal to f of x for some y where x, y is in the relation for the function f. So now the reason that I draw these arrows this way is just a matter of convenience, because we tend to write f of x, and if we look at g of f of x, then we want to take g on the outside. And so we can read from left to right the order of composition, and then put the domain in on the right, and then the output will be this expression here.